it also feels great to know that there's friends and family watching online. So thanks for all for being here. For those of you who do not know, my name is Becky Turrell, and the piece that you just heard is called Sea Glass, and it was performed by Claire Park on the flute and UT on piano. And so this piece was actually commissioned by Claire Park as part of her lecture recital that happened a few weeks ago. And so this past semester, these past few months, we've been working really, really closely, just like sending each other drafts and improvising and recording and everything. So I just have to thank Parky so much for being so part of the creative process of this piece. And you probably heard there's two sections in that piece. The first one was a very kind of piercing section that kind of depicts broken glass. And then the other section has lots of low notes and sustain that kind of represents the ocean kind of softening the broken glass into sea glass. And the next piece that you'll hear is titled Terrains, and it is a three-movement work for clarinet, piano, and viola. And so this piece was inspired basically by things I've seen on the ground while hiking. And so the very first movement is titled Frost, and that has lots of very open gestures, lots of open fifths, harmonics, and again, a lot of sustain. And so this basically kind of depicts like a frozen field, and how when you look at it at first, it seems very, very barren, but if you look really closely, there's lots of a lot of color and really interesting details if you look really closely. The second movement is called Moss, and that's a very playful and melodic piece. And just like how moss kind of grows in every like direction, the harmonies of this piece also kind of like go in every which direction, kind of ad hoc. And the last movement is titled Erosion, and that one uses lots of techniques that kind of recreate the sound of the earth eroding. So please welcome to the stage Muzi, Timothy Coffey, and Laura Avila. So The Moth is a short art song written by my very good friend, Emily Newbold. And she wrote this poem while in California a few years ago. She was staying in a cabin on a blueberry farm in California, picking blueberries. I think the best way to kind of introduce this piece is to just kind of recite the poem. It's very short, so don't be impressed that I have it memorized. So the title is Self-Doubt at Midnight. The moth in my cabin slams himself into a light bulb, thinking it's the moon. Do I believe in something like that, too? And so sadly, Marissa thought I could not be here to perform it in person, but luckily we were able to get a recording. So sit back and relax and enjoy the moment. Also featuring Marissa Plotty on soprano and Musi on the piano.
Do I believe? Shadow in the light follows.
Is called Shadow. It was composed last year as part of the violin composition collaborations. And so you just heard Karis Anderson on violin one and Peter McGarry on violin two. And the inspiration of that piece is kind of takes from the two different meanings of shadow. So the first one being darkness, and then the second one being someone who follows someone else. So Peter, the whole piece, was kind of acting as Harris's shadow, kind of just following him until basically darkness kind of engulfs everything. And so the next piece that you'll hear is going to be the last piece. So unfortunately, we had to cut the string quartet due to a last minute emergency. This time to thank the performers on the string quartet who spent so much time just like putting it all together. And so please, can we give a round of applause to Harris Anderson, Benjamin Straits, Laura Avila, and Aaron Eierstein. And stay tuned, because I believe we will be recording before the end of the semester, so be on the lookout for a awesome recording of Origami. And I'd also like to take this time to give some thank yous out. So first and foremost, I would really like to thank all the performers who performed on my recital. I was telling a lot of people that it's kind of bittersweet that I'm not performing in this recital, but it is also just really, really nice to be able to share my music and my imaginations with so many people. So thank you guys so much for your collaboration and creativity. I would also like to thank my family for being just endlessly supportive of me, not only as a musician, but also just as a human being. So I know you guys are watching right now, so just thank you for everything. I'd also like to thank my friends also for being also very, very supportive, and particularly my two very lovely housemates, Brad and Muse, who will both be performing tonight. Brad's in the last piece here. But also Muse, who played literally half of my recital, so thank you so much. You both are very incredible, and also thank you for watching Lots of Gilmore Girls with me. I very much appreciate that. And then lastly, but not least, I would like to thank my two composition professors, Professor Jorge Grossman and Professor Eva Sumitas. It's just been so inspiring learning from you both these past 2 years, and I think that my compositions have become more daring after studying with you both. So just thank you so much for giving me the tools that I need to experiment and discover. And so thank you so much. And also thank you guys for being here and for watching. So very much appreciate it. So now for the grand finale. So 72 Miles is a wind trio, and the title comes from the length of the New Jersey section of the Appalachian Trail, which is 72 miles. And this past summer, my friend Emily Newbold, who composed the lovely poem you heard a few pieces ago, we hiked the entire thing, not in all in one go, because we're not that good, but in sections. It was just a very, very grounding and humbling experience, and just an insanely colorful experience. And so I was like, I have to write a piece about this. And so basically, the entire piece is kind of built off of the bird call of an eastern towhee, and I'm going to invite Perky onto stage to play this bird call for you. All the different bird calls until I identified it as the eastern towhee. And so then came the very first movement. So you'll hear the first movement most obviously and most clearly. And then, but it's actually like kind of built into all of the other movements less obviously. So if you want to be on the lookout for hearing the tune, that might be something cool to do. So yes, the first movement is called Eastern Towhee. The second movement is Monarch Migration. The third movement is called Timber Rattlesnake, and the fourth movement is Sunrise Mountain. So please welcome to the stage Bradley Johnson, Amy Zeidema, and Claire Park.
Thank you. Thank you.